My goodness, beautiful. Gorgeous.
Thank you.
The sweetness of that scallop with the bite from the mustard cream.
Forget about it.
Wow.
That's good.
Hi, my name is Douglas Williams. I'm the chef and owner of Meter Restaurants. It's no secret that our planet is changing, and with it, what we eat. There is no waiting. We can taste it, we can sense it, we can smell it, we can talk about it, and we can listen to each other about it. And that starts in the kitchen.
Cool. So you did these greens, I assume, in one of those shipping containers?
Yeah, so these were grown in Boston, harvested just this morning.
I'm in the kitchen today with the Museum of Science to ask, what's on tomorrow's menu?
My name is Derek Baker. I am the lead product designer at a company called Freight Farms. I help develop farms in a box, essentially. In its essence, it's an atmospherically controlled, tech-connected, hydroponic facility all inside of a shipping container, so we're able to produce really cool produce. So we've got a couple different mustard greens here. So they're true to their name, it's mustard. So they do have that bite that's gonna hit you in the back of the palate, give you a little nose feel as well, almost like a little wasabi.
Amazing, so do you know what I'm gonna do to your greens today?
I'm excited to find out.
Okay, so I think I'm gonna try to quickly braise these in a little bit of preserved garlic, put that on top of the rice with a poached egg, some Nantucket bay scallops, scallions, all yummy things.
Get my mouth watering.
All right, great, well let's get into it just a little bit. So you wanna take that rice vinegar and pour about 2 capfuls in this poaching water here for the egg. What really is hydroponics?
In its essence, it's a way to deliver everything the plant needs in a nutrient-enriched water solution. So we're taking soil out of the equation here, but preserving all the things that the plant would receive from soil itself. Right. We have this vertical growing system that we install in the container that allows you to produce about the annual consumption of about 2 acres of farmland, all in a 320 square footprint.
Wow, that's incredible.
So in a hydroponic setting, we've got the nutrient-rich water solution, but we're also providing the lighting environment down to the spectrum of the light. We're providing the atmospheric conditions, controlling the humidity, the temperature, the CO2. So we're cultivating the perfect day for these crops. And so every day to them is a beautiful sunny day. There's no seasonal selection. Any season you can have anything you want. You can create the environment in the container to match really anywhere in the world. And so you can create a Thai basil and mimic that exact environment that you would expect that basil to have been grown in.
Wow. How much water are you actually using in a given year or month or day?
We're utilizing between 5 and 10 gallons a day.
Wow.
So that's about 99% less than traditional agriculture, giving you between 1,000 and 1,200 heads of lettuce weekly.
Want to grab me that garlic, please? Do you know mine? Can I actually just use all of this? Because why am I even being light on it?
Too much garlic.
Yeah, you can't have too much garlic.
Right now, the leafy greens that you get have traveled thousands of miles. It's in a large field, it's harvested by a large piece of machinery, and then it's put on a truck and driven for however long. So we're eliminating all of that. These greens were harvested a few miles from here, a few hours ago, in a pesticide-free environment, utilizing no land. It's a pretty stark contrast to the way that food is traditionally grown.
And now we're gonna take your mustard greens and put them inside of this garlic and just quickly cook it down. I mean, this is so tender. Is there something that's heightened by that process that you do with the hydroponic?
Absolutely. I mean, plants are really reactive. So by changing the lighting intensity or spectrum, it's gonna trigger different hormones in those plants that are gonna create different things, whether it's changing the color or the texture and the taste. We can really kind of play around with
it. You can actually dial it in.
We're really able to cultivate a unique plant because of the specific way that we're controlling the environment.
Okay.
Hey, if you want a really hearty head of oak leaf lettuce, this is the setting to use. This is the recipe to follow, so.
Wow. I'm gonna add my scallops to my pan. Why is it important to know where your food is coming from?
Having the food grown in the community gives that community ownership over the food.
Sure.
You're able to grow food healthier because we're not impacting the foliage itself, and they're retaining those natural oils. These are a lot more shelf stable. How often do you get a bag of lettuce from the store and 2 days later it's no good? But it all kind of boils down to just bringing that food closer to the person and really creating an environment which we can cultivate it in a sustainable way.
Beautifully braised mustard greens. Just a little bit of the raw greens on the side. You don't need much. And then we're gonna hit it with a bit of scallion. Why not? Good amount of sesame. Just a bit of fried chili flake.
My goodness, beautiful. Gorgeous.
Thank you. Great. All right, so should we have a little taste of this?
Please.
All right, great.
Wow.
That's good.
The sweetness of that scallop with the bite from the mustard cream.
Forget about.
And of course, garlic.
The raw grape. You know, where do you see this going
I mean, my future is cooking this as much as I can, but I'd say we have a growing planet of growing people who are all hungry, and we need to feed them. And we need to find new ways to do that. And traditional farming is, of course, one way, but it needs help. And we need ways to do it in a sustainable way and activate areas that wouldn't be able to do it otherwise. So I think it's just one sort of tool on our tool belt to make sure that tomorrow has a menu that continues to be sustainable and delicious.
Awesome.
Of course. All right, I'm going in for more again. Yeah.